This morning on The Dish, a queen of Caribbean cuisine, Nina Compton, was born on the beautiful island of St. Lucia, where her father once served as prime minister. After high school years in England, she pursued her dream of becoming a chef, attending the prestigious Culinary Institute of America and working at top jobs in New York and Miami. Then it was off to New Orleans, where she opened Compère Le Pain, and the honors poured in.
In 2017, she was named one of Food & Wine's best new chefs. The next year, she won the James Beard Award for Best Chef South. And last year, she opened her second restaurant, Bywater American Bistro. Chef Nina Compton, good morning,
good morning. Welcome
to The Dish.
You're on a bit of a roll.
And we have a very jealous crew right now. You've got to tell us what we're about to eat.
So I basically brought a little bit of both restaurants to the set today. We're going to start with our poached pickled shrimp. It's a dish we do at Bywater American Bistro with a buttermilk dressing. Then we have our roasted grouper. I love grouper. It's very tropical for me. So I brought that. Just don't eat the habanero, so spicy.
Uh-oh.
And then now we have, it's summertime, so why not have a little bit of jerk corn with a little bit of chili salt, a little bit of lime.
Mm. Oh.
And then we have our mushroom and farro risotto with minted breadcrumbs.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have our lovely banana zeppoli with rum caramel. So.
And this puppy?
And the pineapple, yeah. Pineapple.
Oh.
It's one of our cocktails we do at Bywater American Bistro.
That's right. We're supposed to cheer.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah. So, Nina.
Congrats on your success.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So, let's start with the fact that you were the daughter. You're the first daughter, essentially, on St. Lucia. Your dad was prime minister.
Hmm.
Did that elevate your palate at any point?
I never really saw it as. I just saw my dad as my dad.
Yeah.
You know, I had a very humble childhood where we had, you know, I was spoiled. We had every fruit tree, every vegetable in our backyard. So growing up as a child, it was one of those things where my dad would go into the garden, pick fruit, and make juice for us. You know, we'd have, like, fresh papaya for breakfast. So it's having that childhood in the Caribbean, I was really spoiled because that was the first introduction for me as, you know, farm to table, like from the backyard onto the plate, like you can't beat that.
And the cooking influence, your granny and your mom was
My grandmother was in the kitchen every single morning.
And you used to have bake-offs.
Yeah. We would, because my mom loved baking cakes. So anybody's birthday, she'd always bake in the kitchen. I'm like, Mom, I want to learn to bake. And we started getting really good at it, and we'd make competition. And I'm like, Mom, who has the best cake? And you know how a mom is. She's like, they're both the same, and they both win.
But talk about the influences, though, because, I mean, obviously Caribbean is a big part of it, too. But then, you know, New Orleans was so instructive for you,
yes.
Right?
It was, you know, it's very captivating. That city is just, whenever you go there, it's just, you feel touched by all the senses. The heat, for one, which is great. So how do you cool off? You have a cocktail. And then you walk around and you're eating everywhere. So I think for me it was, you know, a very humble and a very approachable introduction to New Orleans because it is very similar to the Caribbean. It does feel like the most northern Caribbean part of the Caribbean, essentially. So for me it was very natural just to feel at home. You know, the buildings are very similar, they're very colorful, the music is very similar. And the love for food, I mean, you can't beat that.
Yeah, Compère Le Pain was such a hit. And in a city like that, that has known chefs, I mean, they were coming to your restaurant. You got such acclaim now with an American bistro in the Bywater.
Yeah.
A whole new neighborhood.
Yes.
What are you hoping to do there?
You know, I never thought I'd open a second restaurant. And because a restaurant is not easy. It is a lot of work. And I had somebody on my team, Levi Rains, who was just, you know, just light years above anybody I've actually worked with. And, you know, I wanted to give him a platform, give him somewhere so he can shine as well.
Ah.
And, you know, he's really taken it to the next level, and I'm really proud of what we do. And the whole premise is just to have a neighborhood restaurant. I live in the Bywater. And people are like, you're crazy for opening a restaurant there. But I wanted to have people that live in a neighborhood that come to the restaurant that I can see a familiar face. And we have, I would say, 75% I come in and I know almost every person in that restaurant.
That is awesome. Yeah. Well, if you could have a meal, this meal, with anyone, you past or present, who would it be?
It would be, that's a very easy one.
Your father? You have to tell us.
it would be my dad and my grandmother.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because you have to sign the dish. Forgive me. And Chef Nina Compton, thank you so much for sharing your dishes with us. For more on her and this dish, head to our website at CBS This Morning.